Okay, so here's a quick look around camp this Monday. Got our table in use here. And hammock chair and stuff. Chicken coop over there. Still gotta put that tarp up later. Ray showed up. His YouTube channel name is Sh S with a whole bunch of H's. This is his chair. We will build him a bushcraft chair here soon. And Kaz's shelter. My shelter. And what I'm doing right now is building another bushcraft chair, just like this one over here. This one uses a branch with a double Y on it, and I guess I kind of got lucky in finding that one last year because I looked all over and couldn't find another one. So we're going to use three single Ys this year, which should be fine as long as it holds up. But basically, just find a stick with a Y in it, and you get another stick. Let me move my axe and stuff here, and I'll show you. You don't want to just hammer a Y into the ground because you'll break the Y. So, what you do is you get a nice, good, strong, sturdy stick like this, and you sharpen up a point, and then you find out where your Y wants to go, and then you'll hammer this stick down into the ground as deep as you want the Y to be. And then you carefully pull this stick out of the ground, and then you tap the Y into the ground. That way, you don't bust the Y off. Because if you hammer a Y down in the ground, a lot of times, not all the time, but a lot of times, you'll bust off one of these arms, and then it defeats the purpose of having the Y. So that's how you get around with that. Get a hole driving stake, a long hole driving pole to drive the holes for your Ys. And so you put three Ys in, go around the tree. You don't have to go around the tree, but the tree makes for a good backdrop for a backrest, especially if you can get one with a slight slope to it. This one's got a little slope to it. And doing it this way means no cordage is necessary. And there's the other Y there. I have another stake in the ground because this hole is a little loose. So if your hole is a little loose for your Y, just pound another stake into it. And like this one here, pound in a couple sticks in there and it tightens up the Y. You might have to do that from time to time. If your side posts here need to be good, strong side posts because each one of these posts here are going to support majority of the weight, right? So these need to be the strongest along with the Ys. And sometimes, being nice and thick, they won't fit. So you need to take your axe and chop a V notch, or chop it into a V so it fits in the notch like that. And then just give it a little tap and it'll stay nice and snug. And there you have it. Not all that's left is you don't want to use this stick because this stick is our driving stick. We use it for our campfire poker and driving holes in the ground, but I'm going to use it for an example now. But now you just find sticks like that and line it up all the way across out to here, and you're good to go. Now, some people like a nice, deep, long bench, and some people like just a short one. So, what I do is I figure out when I'm deciding how far out to put these Ys. You can just put your back up against the tree, like so, and figure out where your knees are at, and just kind of put the Y where your knee is at. Or you can measure from your hip pointer to your knee, and that's how the distance from the tree to the Y will be. And from your hip pointer to your knee, should be about the same distance approximately from your knee to your ankle. So you could just do this. See that? From the knee to the ankle there, approximately. Just do that, and that gives you a measurement. And that should make for a comfortable chair for you. I do sink the rear one a little bit lower, about an inch or two lower, roughly 2 inches lower then I have the front ones. That way it has a slightly downward slope in the back so that it makes it more comfortable for leaning up against the tree. And that's for my preference. Your preference, you might want a higher back. I prefer a lower back. So it's very, very customizable to your preference, however you want it. And then just make sure that these sticks here can support your weight. Should be able to sit on it individually. Now you're not going to just sit and bounce and plop. You have to sit down gently. No plopping on these types of chairs. Okay? You gotta sit down. You shouldn't plop down in those kind of chairs either. It will hold your weight, you know. So, like you see, nice and comfy. This one's been up for a year and it's still holding my weight as if there's no issues or anything. And the rungs I'm sitting on have been here for a year. We did not replace them. But if I start bouncing up and down on it and jumping up and down on it, or I just plop down on it with all my weight, just go wham, there's a good chance, you know, eventually it's going to break. So take care in how you sit. Don't no plopping, and treat it with respect, and it'll take care of you. I think that goes for everything. Treat your tarp with respect, and your tarp will take care of you. Treat your dog with respect, and he won't bite you. Isn't that right, Kyle Dog? Snoozing over there in the sun. So, speaking of sun, I need to go move my solar panels. But alrighty, I'm gonna stop the video here, go move my solar panels, and then I'll mount the camera so you can watch me cut these logs up and make the bench part.
What's up, old bean? I can't find my saw. I must have left it lying on the floor in the front of our truck.
Yeah, I'm a
got one. I got one. Well, not. It looks similar to that. Mine's a folder one. That one looks like it's a slider in or out, right?
Yeah.
Yep. The same. About the same size and stuff. So that's probably a little heavy dutier than mine. But I just bought mine. It's been on my birthday Christmas list now for a year and a half.
Alright, so that's basically what I'm going to do. I'm going to go find some more sticks now because I'm out of what I got right here for that. Go find some more sticks and I'm going to cut them up. Once you're done and you have enough sticks to make the whole seat, then you come back and you'll take your pocket knife or whatever or your axe and you want to cut these little knobs off so that they don't poke you in the ass and makes it more comfortable for you. Unless you like sitting on the knob, but I don't. So after I get enough to make the whole seat there, and I test them, make sure they're going to be strong enough, then I'll go back and cut those knobs off, and then we'll be done. Okay, so what's next now is you want to take your knife and clean off all these knobs that are on here. Makes for a more comfortable sit. I'll have to hit that one with an axe. Can you bring me my axe there? Thanks. If you scrape the bark off of all your sticks that you use for your projects, then it lasts longer. Leaving the bark on causes the sticks to hold water and will cause them to rot faster. And makes it for a kind of a moist seat for you to sit on after it rains. And holds in dirt and everything else. You take the bark off, and then after it rains once, washes the dirt and stuff off of it, and then you pretty much get a nice clean seat. For the most part.
Yeah. And if you put a few leaves on this side, it'll help hold that heat in, and the sticks that are in there will get warmer faster.
Gotcha. I'm probably just gonna blow out, to be honest with you.
Yeah, that works too.
Kaz is in the background making a campfire to cook some hot dogs. Say hi, Kaz.
What up? You guys gotta come join us next year. Girls are invited too.
Only redheads.
Blondes are okay.
Well, if you invite blondes, then you have to invite the brunettes and the blackheads. And
well, you're the one who said redheads. Ryan's a redhead girl. He likes the redheads. I like the blondes. But technically, we did have a girl out here though. Technically. Does that count?
I don't know if Bloody Mary counts as a girl.
No, I'm not talking Bloody Mary. I'm talking about the girl that showed up.
Mary was a space alien. Her own words, not mine.
There we go.
If you're talking about this year, I'm pretty sure my wife qualifies. I've been with her for, with her for several decades, and I know that...
And technically, we had two girls this year.
I didn't see Bloody Mary was here. What?
No,
what?
Not Bloody Mary. The blonde that showed up.
Oh,
you're kind of the...
The CO.
The conservation officer person. Yes, she showed up, and she was really cool.
Thanks, buddy.
Yeah.
You got it. Don't let your beard on fire.
Don't worry.
He's like Dave Canterbury. His beard is what you use to start the fire with. I've
done that a few times. Exactly. Not let my beard on fire, but...
He just scrapes his beard on a rock and it throws sparks and poof.
That's the best way to get one started first thing in the morning for coffee is just dig around until you find an ember. And
that's what I did this morning.
Yeah. That's what I always do. Who's Dave Canterbury?
From Pathfinder School.
I've seen some of those videos posted.
He was like season one and part of season two for...
He set his face on fire?
No. It was a comedy skit.
Oh.
But he was on season one and part of season two for Dual Survivor. And he owns a school, survival school and stuff. He's pretty good. He has some things I agree with, some things I don't.
I singed a few once when I first started growing this years ago when I was cooking in the house, and I bent down to see how high the flame was underneath the pan, and I singed a few in the front, just a few wild ones that were sticking out in the front, and I'm like, whoa, I better watch that in the future. That's the closest I've ever come, though. It was enough to make me aware of, whoa, this thing's hanging down there. I better watch what I'm doing.
He did a comedy mock video or something, and he's like, a real man doesn't need a flint and steel. He's got
his beard.
And he takes a rock or something, and he goes, shh, shh, and sparks go flying off, and then whoosh, got a big fire. It was fucking hilarious.
He did that?
Yeah, it was one of his comedy videos. It's probably still up. It's probably got over 1 million views. It was great. But alrighty, let's get you a close-up of the... chair here. So there's the chair. Kaz, have a seat.
I'm cheating in the
Give 101 the hot dogs and you come have a seat here. You're not camera shy.
No.
And remember, no plopping.
No plopping? I can't
no
plop?
No plop. You don't have to be gentle. You can sit down like a normal chair. But
I said I couldn't plop.
You know, plopping is like, boom, just dropping down. Like a lot of big fat people like to just plop down into things.
My God.
Yeah. There you go. There you have it. Comfy?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Gonna use the rest of that stick there to add the last couple of rungs to the other chair over there. And then we're gonna start chopping fire. Well, then I'm gonna make my buck saw. And we'll get to that on video. And then we're going to make firewood and then water run. So stay tuned.